Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Axianerve, and welcome to the Medieval / Gothic Castle Tutorial. This is part dos. The first part, we did the outer defensive walls, I guess you could call them that. All of this, and this part, this episode, we're going to do these walls right here. I already kind of did the sign so you can see what we're going to be working with today. It's just sort of the corner bit right here, and then the start of the front walls. Some things to note before I begin, though. I made a slight change in the walls. I put these towers one block to the inside. On the regular build, they are one block to the outside, which leaves us with this little gap right here. And our walls right up here don't intersect with these. On this one, though, once we get to that point, we are going to have to change that up a bit. So I guess that, I don't know, maybe next episode or an episode after that. But once we get to that point, I'll have to just improvise this bit, this sort of front entrance area. This stuff should be fine, but up here we'll definitely have to change because this wall will be moved to right there. So I have some ideas, but we'll cross that ridge when we get to it. Other things to note, though, I went ahead and did some little minor interior work for the towers in case you guys just wanted to know. I don't know. Put some chests in here. Same thing for the corner towers. Just some chests. And ladders, of course. Anyway, let's get started today. We'll start with this wall right here and then wrap around to the other side. But we'll do it on this side, this left-hand side. First thing we're going to do is take stone bricks and we're going to come down here. And this will be the start of our wall. The left-hand side, the left or that left side. This will be the right side. Blah, 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 blah. This is going to go one diagonal block from the crenellation right here. Right above. Or actually, it's just going to be, this is all going to change to stone bricks right here. So it's right, it's right there. I don't know how else to describe it. Right on the, it's right on the corner. Right to that. It's 16 blocks high from the ground. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... Dang it. 7, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Should be matching that one. Let's double check. Because I don't know if I counted correctly. Yep. Okay, cool. Yeah, there we go. So, 16 blocks high, and we're going to go 9 blocks wide. So that's already 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, we'll continue this one down. Whoops. There we go. Knock all of this off and replace that with stone bricks. Okay, so we have this. Of course, this all gets filled in with stone bricks just like that. Our roof is just going to be a regular, I guess, triangular roof. So we're just going to go up one level at a time, sort of pyramid style, I guess. The top, just leave flat, 3. We'll do a weird sort of roof to this. It's going to be a double stair roof with little pieces of slabs thrown in there. I don't know. But just leave it 3 on top. Because right on top of this is going to go spruce wood planks and stuff. So we'll leave that to when we do the roof. Now, this whole thing is going to be 5 blocks wide, so 5 blocks to the inside of our whole area. So we already have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we can bring this one up as well, 16 blocks to match that. There we go. And now for the wall right here is 3 blocks to the left, right here. 14 blocks high, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, and maybe you fill this in right there. Shaboom. Alright, so the corner bits right here. So this wall is going to go right here, and the wall is going to go right there. A little weird. Alright, they're 13 blocks wide, so let's go ahead and do that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13. Should match with that. Yep, there we go. 13 blocks. Let's bring this down to the ground. Okay, and the other wall to this side doesn't intersect exactly right here. it's going to go a little... It's going to be right there. What we're going to have to do, though, is put another column of stone brick to the end of this wall, and another column to the end of this wall. Now, this won't... Well, this have an effect on the roof. As you can see right there, we'll have this two-block ledge, I guess, before we start our stairs for our roof. Roof. I sound like a dog when I say that. So we'll bring this back up and just repeat the same thing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. Back down. So it's 14 blocks, including the little corner bits. But those won't have stairs on them, so it's a little confusing. Let's put two more onto this one. It's three blocks, and then one, two, three, four, and that's five. Knock all that out. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Should be right there. Yep. All right. So go ahead and put our stone bricks for this. Okay. Now for the roof, for these ones, we're going to do the same style and start regular right here. Just leave the one block up, and we're going to stop right here. So we'll have two blocks right there instead of one. And then it just goes back to normal. Okay, just like that. So give me 1 sec, and I'm going to fill in all these. Well, actually, we'll just move right over here to this side. It's already filled. I don't know what I'm talking about. All right. So for our windows, we're going to put two rows of sort of big giant windows right here. And then four 1x2 or 2x... It depends on how you view it. Small windows and the one on top right up there. The big windows are two blocks... Or first one is two blocks from the ground. So we're going to knock out four blocks right there. Oh, sorry. Three. And then four blocks high. So one, two, three, four. We're going to skip a block. Knock out another chunk. Skip a block. Knock out another chunk. So there should be two stone brick columns right at the end, or the corner right here. Okay, we're going to do the same thing on this one. Oops. There we go. Okay, now for the next level, we're going to skip one block. Cheat and look over there. Or it's actually two, and then a another row, I do believe. Yeah, two blocks, and then we're gonna do another section of windows, same size, same sort of location, I guess, on the wall, vertically. So two columns right up here. We're going to skip, cheat again, we're going to skip one block, put down four windows right there. And these are going to be three blocks from that side, and then one, two, three, four blocks from the corner right at that level, and then one all by its lonesome right up there at the top. Okay, and of course do the same on that wall. We're gonna fill these, or actually we're going to put down stone brick stairs to make archways on all of these. So two upside down stairs on either corner. Okay, just like so. And then on the other side, we're going to put down glass. And these are going to go right here to the inside. Whoops, just like so. Okay, I'll just do this bottom row. No need to be repetitive and do the top row or the second row. Okay, come back over here. Now, to add some variation to our wall, we're going to replace these bottom three, or these three stone bricks, with upside down spruce wood stairs, and the bottom three with just regular smooth stone. Okay, just like that. Same thing on this side. Boom. Boom. And that one. Okay. On this next level, we're just going to replace those with upside down stairs. Okay. Now, to add some more detail, since it's a little weird just having this flat wall, we're going to add in two stone bricks, the fronts of these, just like that, and then an upside down stone brick stair. And then a cobblestone wall piece. Boom. And then a fence post right on top of that. Okay, and down on the ground, just put down a regular stair. All right. Now, in front of this stone, you can also add some more detail by putting in some oak leaves. Like that. Just add some color to this gray wall. Now, right here, I'm going to run into an issue because I'm going to put this right there. I'm just going to repeat this like so. You can put down a stair if you want, facing this way or that way. Whoop. Or just a block. It's entirely up to you. Kind of whatever you feel looks best to your preference. Take that. All right, and that's it for this wall. And then up here, put down just glass panes. Fill those in. And boop. Okay, and repeat the same thing on that side. Give me one sec, and let me do that real quick, and then we can move on to the other walls. So I'll be right back with you guys. All right, guys. So far, your walls should look just like this. If you want to include the leaves, of course. Now we're going to move on to some small little thing on the corner right here. Just 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 blocks high pillar of stone bricks with two stairs on the bottom, two upside down stairs on the top, and then a netherrack piece. Here we go. Right here. Then two more stairs to the inside, and then just light that puppy up. Just add some, I don't know, some detail, I guess, on the wall. It's kind of weird. I don't know why I put it in there. But I don't know. It looks cool, kind of like a little fiery piece of stuff. There we go. Put those back. And let's grab our... What else do we need? Grab one of those and one of those. Alright, so let's move on to our walls right here. And right over here. We'll just do this one. And just repeat the same pattern on that side as well. We're going to take some stone bricks. And we're going to put down two block high pillars right here on the bottom. This is going to be four of them. So we're going to skip a block on this side. Put one, two. Skip a block. One, two. Two and two. Just like that, so where it's evenly distributed with upside down stairs right on top, just like so. And we're gonna put four windows right above these with upside down stairs at the bottom, I believe. Yeah. Oh, sorry, these are regular. My bad. Those are regular, and these are upside down for the window. Knock out two blocks above those, and then put a regular stair, or sorry, upside down stair right above where the windows are gonna go. Then we can grab some glass panes, put them in these spaces, just like that. And right above these, we're going to put two of our arch windows, same design as on those walls. So one, two, three, put down three upside down spruce wood stairs, same thing on this side. And then we'll get the glass already. And then knock out these blocks. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 high. Put down our upside down stairs. There we go. Just like that. I think these are actually shorter on this one, but you can go up to four pretty easy. I don't know why I didn't. It looks fine. I guess I just didn't want to. Here we go. And there we go. Alright, so that's it for that wall. It's pretty simple wall. Nothing too fancy. Now for the roof. We're going to do just regular stair roof here, so just up, and then right here, go down, okay, and it's one block overhang, there we go, and back down, okay, and then upside down stairs underneath these. You can also put dark oak wood for the roof. It also looks pretty good as well. I made this like a year ago, so it wasn't dark oak wood back then, but that will also work well with the style. Now for the top up here, we're going to put down planks, just like so, and then two more stairs, or actually, you know, straight down, but another stair on top of the top stairs, like so. And then you can fill that in with spruce wood planks. Down here we're going to put down an upside down stone brick stair in between these two spruce wood stairs, and then one more right here. And then a block, and then a regular stair, just like that. Looks a little weird, I think. Oh, sorry, no. Not a block, just a regular stair. There we go. That looks better. Still a little weird, but better. Okay, and then on the other side, put down a block, and then we're going to make a sort of a fence roof thing, kind of like that, because that looks really gothic. Not really, but it's as much as you can, really. Okay, now after we do the roof for these, we can extend this down, and then we'll add in the little slab pieces. That sort of look. I don't know what they would be called in the real world. I don't even know if they have these in the real world, but look cool. Little slab pieces. That's why I call them. Okay, so we'll bring this this roof down to meet up with this one, and we'll just repeat the same pattern on this roof, and then come down. Okay, once again, remember it just stops right there. Okay, and back down. Boop. Okay, put on our overhang. And for this corner, right here in between these walls, we're going to put down our upside down stairs. Okay, right here. And right there. Just like that, and then fill in this little space with a plank block. Okay, and it should match. Should be at the same level as this one. Yep. Alright. Let's put on our overhang. Nope. Come on there. There we go. Good stair. Good job. Okay, and our upside down stairs. There we go. And down. Alright. So up here we'll put down spruce wood plank. Upside down stone brick stair. Then a plank, I think, yeah. And then an upside, wait, no, plank. Then an upside down stair. Then a regular one, right? I think, yeah. There's stairs right there. Stairs right there. Okay. Then a plank, and then a fence. Cool, just like that. All right, now let's connect up these roofs. Roofs. Now we'll put another stone brick block to cover up that space right there. Continue this down, turn the corner and connect those up. Same thing for these, and then just bring these down. It's pretty simple, besides the weird crazy roof. Okay. And down. Alright, so now it gets a little crazy. We're gonna take these down, turn the corner, come down like that. Now to add in our slab pieces, let's grab a slab here. And we're gonna count, I think, three blocks from the side. I believe that should work. Yeah, three blocks. Skip two. Another one, skip two, and then another one. So there's two blocks in between. Of course, let's go to the other side and just fill this in so you can see what it looks like from this side. Okay, and our planks. Gonna go right there. Up here. Down. Alright, so that's 2, 3. I think, yeah. There we go. Skip 2. 2. Okay. Then we can knock off that plank and that plank. We already did that one. And then put down our slabs there, there, and there. You can keep those, or you can keep the slabs right there if you'd like. Or when you're doing the interior. Let me find one where I was working on it. I know I did one of these. I was doing it. Let's see. That was one of these. I think it was this one. Maybe. Nope. Was it this one? If you keep them open, if you keep the slab open. Yeah, here we go. It adds a little bit of light to the ceiling. It looks kind of cool. Although, I don't... What? Let's just take all those off. I think that works better. Let's go right there. There. Oh, there's only two for this one. My bad. So yeah, it adds sort of a little skylight up there. It's not much, but it's cool. Cool little skylight. Even though cool is kind of subjective, but whatever. It's cool to me. Dang it. Okay, so let's continue our roof, or continue our roof down, like so. And we're just going to put these down. And that, I believe, is going to turn. Yeah, we're just going to extend our roof just a little bit to meet up with this one. Now, we're going to have another roof running across, as you can see, all the way down to this other side. But for now, we'll just stop it right here. For our fences, we're going to put down fence, and then these are all fences. What? Here we go. Fence gate. There we go. God, this whole castle is just like a Frankenstein's monster. There's so many different variations that I was just working with. Alright, so this is a little hard to describe. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to put a block right here, right in the corner, with a fence on top and a fence on either side, and we're going to find the right number of gates, or the right combination of gates and fences to reach the end, where it looks a little natural. I think this should be two fences, and then two gates, and then a fence. Nope. Okay. Let's try three. Three wouldn't work. I think just one. There we go. Yeah. So one fence, one gate, one fence, one gate. All the way down this one. We can do two. Two fences, or two gates and a fence. That pattern should work. Alright, and then put our slabs in right here. So 1, 2, third block. Skip 2, put one right there. Same thing on the side. Boom, and boom. And we can put in those just like that. Alright, so give me one sec and I'll finish up the roof for these. And then we can work on this weird corner piece thing. So I'll be right back with you guys. Alrighty guys, so this is what it should look like so far. I went ahead and did the roof right here. I only did the left-hand side. We didn't really need to do the other side right now for this tutorial. Right here, for the corner bit, you can go ahead and extend this wall down a couple blocks. I just did like 4 or 5. It's going to keep extending down until we reach this little bit right here. Which we'll get to in another episode. But it should be fine to extend these down, because this little crenellated defensive wall piece thing only starts at the end of the roof. You don't have to worry about that hitting this roof bit. Anyway, one thing I didn't do is this little roof right here to add some detail. It's entirely optional, since it's a little weird. to have to work with for the interior. But to do this, we're going to come over here. This one, we're going to go up one block. So this level right here, this is where the wall is at. We're going to count four blocks from the outside. So one, two, three, four. We're going to put one block right here. Skip one. Put one right there. Can knock those out. Take that out. These are going to be two blocks high, just like that. And then one right up here. And we can go ahead and put down these blocks back there. Extend that right there. And let's put in a glass pane block, just like so. And then a little small roof is going to come up here. One block overhang. Okay, now for the roof, it's going to be slabs, just like that. And on the very end, we're going to put down a regular stair facing outward, so it looks just like that. Let's put down our upside down stairs just on those bottom ones. And that's it for that little small roof. And of course, repeat the same thing on that side. And that's it for this tutorial, guys. It's a little longer, but we get a lot done today. Next episode, we should be able to complete the entrance bit right here. Make sure right there. There we go. Show you what it looks like. The towers and then this wall right there. And then we can do... I don't know how much it will be for that. Anyway, yeah, we'll do this for sure next episode, though. Two towers and then the wall right there and the little gate. For this stuff, go ahead and finish these walls or this corner and then those corners, and just put on some roofing work. Now, you don't have to do it all the way like this, but you can if you'd like, of course, because the roof stops right here for this tower. But the top just does go all the way down, and of course all the way across up to this one, so you can at least do the top bits, the top couple of stairs for sure. Though, for sure, the corners right there and there, you should be able to do those with no problem. Other than that, guys, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment, rating, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.